What's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers? It's Kush back at it again with another Giants update video. Kyle Van Noy was released by the Miami Dolphins just like an hour or so ago. Now, I couldn't make a video immediately because I was actually on Big Blue in the Bronx's podcast. Hopefully that's going to be out later today. I think it's usually out around the same day. Shout out to Alex from Big Blue in the Bronx for having me on. I had a good time there. You guys, when it comes out, definitely go check it out. But Kyle Van Noy released from the Dolphins after just playing one of the 4 years that he signed on to play with them as a free agent last year. And as we all know, Kyle Van Noy last year was a target, a player that the Giants were looking to bring on because of his familiarity with the coaching staff, and also because Kyle Van Noy, I think himself, was looking at the Giants as well. So with him being released in an abrupt move, really, that the only way it makes sense, because with the release, it frees up $9.775 million in the Dolphins cap space. The only way this makes sense is that they're looking to bring in somebody that might have a bigger contract, whether that's a wide receiver, because let's not forget, the Dolphins right now, a lot of people are mocking them to have a wide receiver in the draft, somebody like Ja'Marr Chase or Devontae Smith. Maybe they're freeing up that cap space because they're looking to bring in one Allen Robinson or one Kenny Galladay, who I personally think Galladay is a better fit for them for what they're looking for, you know, in terms of their outside receiver. They're probably going to look for a bit more explosive guy, not necessarily a bit more of a possession and physical receiver that Allen Robinson is. I could be wrong on that. That's just my thoughts on that. So they could be looking to do that, or what a lot of people have been saying is they could be looking to make a push to bring in one of these quarterbacks, whether it's Deshaun Watson, who's been linked to them ever since his trade rumors began, or Russell Wilson. And you guys know how I feel on that with the whole thing. I really think, and I really wish, that they would stick with Tua, because I mean, you tanked like what, 2 straight years to get the guy, you finally get him, and now you're gonna give him up, albeit for a top 5 quarterback in the NFL, that without a doubt, if Russ or Deshaun is on this Dolphins team, they're going to be a playoff team, and they're going to be a competitor. They're going to be one of those teams in contention, you know, in the playoffs. So I'm not saying that's not going to happen. I just kind of wish they would stick with the guy they've waited so long to get, and now that it almost seems as if they're a little bit too willing to give up on him. That's just me, right? But I think that it's either going to be them freeing up cap space for that big trade for that big quarterback, or they're just looking to sign one of these receivers that could come in and make an impact immediately. That way they could use their 3rd overall pick to get one Penei Sewell to also protect their quarterback. We'll see what happens, man. We'll see what happens. But with Kyle Van Noy and the Giants now, he is somebody, like I said, that we were looking at last year, and he was looking at us as well. And Van Noy is definitely somebody I would be completely willing to have on the Giants. Now, one misconception to clear up. It's not really a misconception, kind of like a misunderstanding. A lot of people say that Kyle Van Noy fits the Giants system. In a way, yes, he does, because of his familiarity with Patrick Graham, who was the defensive coordinator on the Dolphins in 2019. However, the one thing that must be said about Patrick Graham when he was with the Dolphins in 2019 is that he ran a different type of system than what he's running with the Giants right now. He was a lot more of a man coverage, press coverage, slash blitzing system there. I don't know the exact name for it, but they ran a lot of man plays, a lot of press coverage plays, and the Dolphins were blitzing a lot when Patrick Graham was there, versus over with the Giants, where we had one of the least amount of blitzes in the entire NFL this year, and we were definitely a more zone coverage team. And so I just want to say, it may have been the same scheme, maybe it was a different scheme, but it was different styles of play on the defense, what Patrick Graham was doing in Miami and what he's doing over here with the Giants. Now, of course, he shifted to that zone cover scheme and less blitzing with the Giants because he had to adapt to his players. That's why we love Patrick Graham. He adapts to what his players can do and then makes something great out of it. This was born out of necessity, and because it was born out of necessity, what Patrick Graham cooked up, it gave us an incredible Giants defense that was ranked 9th overall by the end of the year, and it gave us, with James Bradbury, the best year of his career, Pro Bowl year, in my opinion, All Pro year, one of the best cornerbacks in the league, developing in one of these zone cover systems. And I'm just going to quickly bring up, that's why I had us in my mock draft taking a zone cornerback, because think about this to yourself. Why would you want to change the type of coverage we're running when James Bradbury was so dominant as a number one corner in the NFL this year? You're going to go back to a man cover scheme, which he has been running for most of his career over in Carolina, and he was at best an above average cornerback there. Don't you want to keep the scheme that gave him this success? Don't you want to keep the scheme that honestly gave our entire defense success? I'm just going to say that. But Calvin Noy, can he fit into this? 100%. Let's not get it twisted, because he knows Patrick Graham, because Patrick Graham knows him, because he knows Joe Judge from the New England days, and Joe Judge knows him. And because, most importantly, Calvin Noy is one of the most versatile players in the NFL, especially at the linebacker position. He could adapt to really, in my opinion, any defense that he goes to. That's just, especially at this point in his career where he's seen it all. You know, he's seen basically anything you can imagine in the NFL when it comes to schemes and whatnot. I think he'll have no problem adapting to that, but he'll come in. And Van Noy is a linebacker that plays on both the inside and outside. This is why I like this. If we bring him in and he stays playing on the inside and outside, him rotating at that second linebacker position with one Tay Crowder, in my opinion, solves our need at second linebacker. We don't need to spend a draft pick on a linebacker in the draft if we have Calvin Noy and Tay Crowder rotating at that second position with Blake Martinez right there. I think that perfectly solves it. And I'm going to get into his stats now, because he's shown that he's a capable linebacker when he's playing in the middle, and he shows that he's a capable linebacker when he's coming off the edge as well. So let's get into it. Over the past 2 years, in 2019 in New England and in 2020 in Miami, 2019 in New England, and obviously Van Noy's been there since 2016, so he was also there when Graham was over there as one of the defensive assistants in New England as well. So 2019, he finished his season with 6.5 sacks, 56 total tackles, one defensive touchdown, 7 tackles for loss, 15 QB hits, and then in terms of the pass defended side of things, 3 passes defended, 3 forced fumbles. And then 2020 in Miami, he had 6 sacks, 69 total tackles, with 10 of them for loss, 10 quarterback hits, and 2 forced fumbles with 6 passes defended. He was also second in all NFL linebackers in pressures last year. I will say, definitely a bit more productive on the pass rushing side of things than the pass defending side of things, you know, outside versus inside, but I still got faith in him. He's been a guy throughout his career that people know is a reliable inside linebacker when it comes to the pass, and that's what we're looking for at the second inside linebacker position. And once again, I've said this even for the second cornerback position, we're not looking for the best player available for so that we could have a team just stacked with the best at each position. No, we need just a reliable guy that we know when he's back there can take care of the passing lanes. And in my opinion, with Van Noy and Tay Crowder, who's shown potential Crowder in his rookie year, that's going to be a pretty good rotation to have next to Blake Martinez, especially if we continue to improve the secondary, whether that's in the draft or free agency. That's only going to help out the guys at the middle level. But you guys gotta let me know what you think about this. One thing I forgot to say, Logan Ryan, go get this man. You said you're going to do recruiting. You guys played on the Patriots together. You guys were free agents together. Go over there, get him over here. And I'm going to pop up something Van Noy said about, you know, medical, you know, the Dolphins medical team and whatnot. Guess what? Giants take care of their players. You could ask Logan Ryan about that with him and the situation that happened with his wife, bro. Yo, get over here, Calvin Noy. And, you know, my idea of if we get Van Noy, then we don't need to really target middle linebacker that much anymore. And I will say, if we get Van Noy, that probably means somebody that we don't bring back will be a Kyler Fackrell, who is a guy, you know, a veteran, cheap edge, cheap outside linebacker that we signed last year that we're probably going to be looking to re-sign this year. But Van Noy is probably going to cost, I'd say, maybe around $7-8 million. Kyler Fackrell costs a lot less, but because we're going to bring Van Noy on, I would say Fackrell would be a casualty of that. So that's what I got for y'all today. Let me know what you think, whether it's about the idea or anything else I said in the video. Also, keep your eye out tonight at 9 will be the premiere of my mock draft 2.0, and then right at 9:30 would be the call-in show. That's it for now. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.